So it might not look like much right now, but that is my Triumph Bonneville that I just picked up. It has some pretty cool stuff going on. However, it was totally rattle can painted and looked terrible. Let me show you what we're dealing with here.
The paint is like really inconsistent. It's kind of streaky and splotty. I think it looks bad. So what I've been doing is I've been taking some like paint remover to it and just bringing it back to that kind of bare metal. I've been leaving it a little bit sort of rough and raw. I know I could sand it and make it really shine and really get rid of all the little black former paint spots, but to be honest, I kind of like it like this. I kind of like it sort of showing a little bit of its history and where it's been. We're gonna do the same thing to the tank, and then we're gonna seal it all, and then we're gonna be putting it all back on the bike. Because right now she is very, very naked.
And I've just been using this super remover. It's honestly, it works super, super well. Some stuff I'm not bothering to remove the paint because it's gonna be underneath the seat. But yeah, this whole tank, we gotta just tape up, prep. I've already drained it overnight, so it's good to go. Keep in mind, this is not a how-to video in terms of how you should do it. This is just in terms of how I'm doing it. I have no painting experience. I have no custom bike bullshit experience. This is just how I do this kind of thing. And it's my first time doing it, so I really don't know what I'm doing. So take whatever you see with a grain of salt. Okay, bye.
And like all things on this channel, I will be linking to what I use in the description box and in the comment section under the video. So if you want to get the exact products that I use because they seem to be working well, you can do that and save yourself a bunch of time with not buying crappy products. Get this stuff instead. So now you can see that all the old paint is starting to bubble off. We're gonna give it 15 minutes and then we're gonna scrape as much as we can off of the scraper. Yeah, the fenders were pretty easy work. The gas tank took a lot more time because just more surface, more different angles. You kinda have to hold it awkward, but you know, get the job done every time, right? And I'm doing this because I wanna bring this bike back to a little bit of its former glory, which I know is kind of stupid because it's not really gonna be glorious when I'm done with it. But there's a difference between like ugly, crappy looking and like that's ugly but that's cool, you know? So I want to try and get towards that. That's ugly but that's cool. Yeah, and also at the same time kind of pay a little bit of tribute to the paint that she's been wearing for 20 years of her 22 year life. That's the plan. Hi, by the way, if you're new here, I'm Adrian from eMotorcycle. I make videos aimed at helping motorcyclists. I've shared quite a few Bonnevilles that have come and gone through this garage. And I can honestly say that this one here has the best suspension of any Bonneville I have ever ridden. It has front suspension changes, include Racetech Made in USA springs and cartridge emulators. And on the back, it has Made in Canada Stadium rear shocks. Feels so, so good. The suspension was professionally dialed in by Accelerated Technologies. Really, really know their stuff. They did fantastic work with this bike. And I guess that's a good segue to the performance side. It has had a bunch of performance stuff done too. It had the original carburetors replaced with KNCR carbs, the stock airbox, and all of your standard Bonneville air related mods. It has the exhaust from Staintune, which is made in Australia, a high performance CDI box installed in there. And of course the carbs have all been jetted and set up. But the point is that at one point this old girl, she really stood out. This thing's always been kind of different and unique and kind of trying to step outside of the box. And I think in a sea of glossy black painted Triumph Bonnevilles, this thing actually was different and unique and an individual. And I want to kind of pay a little bit of tribute to that, I guess. I kind of think of bikes a little bit like people and how we are as people. We can't fully erase our past. The lessons that we learned along the way of our walks of life, the good and the bad, it'll always be a part of us. And all we can do is try and grow from it and try and find ways to keep moving forward and to use those experiences to keep getting better. And I think it's important to never stop trying to improve. Especially I think if you feel too slow or too old or too much at a disadvantage, I think that's when you need to push the most to be yourself, to better yourself, to create and to do and to have your work reflect who you are as an individual, to stand out and carve your little notch into the universe and to never stop chasing whatever your next step or your next goal is. I think that's the best time to do it. So this motorcycle here, I think it's perfect for that. It's sat for years, it's unused, it's nearly forgotten, and we don't as people all get the luxury of a second chance at life, of moving to a new place, of a fresh start. And even those people who do get a second shot at life and a fresh start, they don't ever really get to carry, they don't really get to ever get to just go on with a totally clean slate. They still have to carry those little paint chips from their past with them. anybody who's ever come out of cancer, of drug addiction, of any kind of addiction, really, whatever, if you've had any trauma, any tragedy, you carry that, and that's completely okay. And at the same time, if somebody else one day in the future buys this bike and decides they want to repaint it altogether, that's okay too, because the way I see it, your past, it dictates who you were at that moment. It doesn't dictate who you're going to be in the future.
That's a cool bike.
Yeah, it looks good.
That's a cool bike.
Yeah, it looks really good.
It's still kind of ugly, but it's cool ugly.
As for me and who I'm going to be going for a ride. So thank you so much for watching. If you want to encourage me to keep being me and keep on creating and keep trying to do my best stuff, please hit that like button. It really, really, really helps me out, helps my channel out. So I really appreciate you guys hitting the like button. And if you want to see more of what I end up creating, hit subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Adrian from eMotorcycle. Ride safe, but have fun. Peace.